to see four different nations contest the semi-finals. No surprises, it's Zheng and Huang Yachong once again in this showpiece event. Such a great crowd as always here in the Astoria Senayan. And they will make plenty of noise, I can tell you that. Nice little countdown going on the court as they get ready for the players to come in very shortly indeed. Can hear the players getting introduced. Thus, our officials are coming onto this court. This is the 14th edition of the Indonesia Masters. Tournament has grown and grown. It's been a super 500, apart from in 2021 when it was promoted to a 750. Of course, we had a truncated calendar that year, and everyone was playing in Bali, in the little bubble there. A tournament that has been dominated by Indonesians since its inception. They've taken 43% of the winners' medals. That's 28 out of 65 across those previous 13 editions. Huang Yachong coming out there with Zheng Tawei in front. They are the pair to beat. They have made this tournament their own, haven't they? Having won it four times previously. There's no doubt they will be the favourites here against Hiroki Midorikawa and his partner Natsu Saito, who have never gone beyond the second round this year, so this is a big deal. Zheng Tawei and Huang Yachong have won this 18, 19, 20 and 22, and they also have won every single match they played against this pair, and all black. Three, and by the way, all three black have been extremely comfortable. At least one game has been extremely one-sided. Will that happen again today?
Who will receive? Okay. Thank you.
Well, this tournament has been full of surprises and upsets, so you just never know here. Nothing can be taken for granted. Dunks away, 26, 175 centimetres tall from one, so of course, the current world number one and a multiple world champion, 2018, 19, 22, second in 2017 and 23, along with his partner here, Huang Yachong, is 29 from Guito, 165 centimetres tall. Incredibly, they are only silver medalists at the Olympics, of course, losing to Huang Dongping and Wang Yiliu. They want to correct that next year. Asian Games champions in 2018 and currently as well. They've dropped a couple of games along the way. It's not been smooth sailing, I think it's got to be clear there. And a tight one, especially against Terry He and Jessica Tan of Singapore. That was arguably their closest match, but it ended 21-19 in the final game. We've been Asian champions before in 2022 as well. We'll tell you about the number of titles they won in a short while. Hiroki Midorikawa is 23, 161 centimeters tall, not too far away from Tokyo in Saitama, and not far away from his best ranking of 12th, achieved towards the end of last year. His partner is Natsu Saito, also 23, also from Saitama. The pair of them have won one title together on the HSBC BWF World Tour. That is the Canada Open last year. They were runners-up in that same tournament, 2022, and last year as well. This is their path to the final. They had to play Jungten Bang and Wei Yashin, which is a fantastic achievement.
Ready
there
to play.
Third seed, they won that in three. Ramento Spoko from Indonesia is our umpire. And he'll be supported by Jörg Huppertz from Germany.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Zheng Shiwei and Huang Yacheng, China. And on my left, Hiroki Midorikawa and Natsu Saito, Japan. Huang Yacheng to serve to Natsu Saito. Level, play.
So here we go then, the first of five finals, mixed doubles. The Chinese to get us going.
One, well, love.
As I said, they are such an accomplished pair, Zheng Shiwei and Huang Yacheng. 29 titles Zheng Shiwei has won in his time.
Service over, 1-4.
On the HSBC BWF World Tour, along with Yacheng. It's hugely impressive,
two,
isn't it?
One.
Last year alone, they won the Malaysia Open, the All England, the Indonesia Open, the Japan Masters, China Masters, and the World Tour Finals. Six titles last year. Runs up at the Denmark Open. Only final that they didn't win. So six finals they won, one they lost. Odds very much in their favor. And as I said, they've made this tournament their very own. No one has won more tournaments than they have at the Indonesia Masters. Just wide.
4-2.
Oh, that's a lovely stop drop. Midorikawa taking leap out of his compatriot, Yuta Watanabe. Does that so well. I don't think anyone else in the world can do it as well as him. Good job there. And they're holding their own at the moment in these early stages. Midorikawa and Saito. We don't get to too many finals. Last year, there were lots of early exits. So as I said, they won the Canada Open and got to the semis of the German Open and Hong Kong Open. Final of the Australian.
Service over.
Semis of the Thailand Masters.
Four.
There are two semis that they won.
Six.
Four that they lost, and within the actual finals of the two finals that they played in, they won one and lost one. So it's stark contrast to their opponents here. We've talked about the conditions here over the last few days, and there's been more of a sideways drift than anything else, going from left to right as we look at it on the screen. Not as much really going lengthways. So you see a lot being played on this. As we look at it, the forehand side, the left-hand channel, really. Chance out by Midorikawa.
Service over, 8-5.
Looked like it just hesitated there.
Hold.
Again, not hit that cleanly.
9-5.
Now the problem is with just away Huang Yachong, you don't want to give them any kind of lead. 4 points is already quite daunting, I can tell you, with this pair. Oh, he's done that beautifully, hasn't he? Going towards Saito repeatedly with some stop drops, and then changed it up towards Midorikawa on the smash. So a bit of an element of surprise. The lead is now 5.
11-5.
And they go into the interval with a comfortable 6-point lead already, the Chinese pair. 11-5 in the first game. Again, he's played that quite well with Midorikawa, the stop drop.
6-11.
A couple times now already. Need to look at other weapons too. Veering out. Oh. She missed that one, didn't she?
7-11.
Away, playing it a little bit late. A couple of quick points here for the Japanese. And just can't take chances with that drift. They're playing on the front foot here, the Japanese. And it's paid dividends.
8,
3 in a row.
11.
their best run of this game so far. Nice little comeback here.
Service over.
And they finally break that run.
Service over. 9-12.
Was looking very good at the start, or at the interval, has now been cut to just 2. It was a 6-point lead. Only 2 points in it now. Easily put away by Saito. This is so much better
11,
for the Japanese. How often have we seen that the interval makes such a difference? Getting sporadic 11. Points at the moment, took away Huang Yachong. They lead by 3 here. It's precarious. Make that 2.
Service over.
Seem to have lost their way. The Japanese 14. Have been so much more proactive. Yeah, she saw the space down the line there.
Service over.
Huang Yachong.
12.
Stepping in nicely. Exploited that. Just a tad long.
16-12.
It's a nice cushion to have, though, the 4 points for the Chinese pair. Take a chance, had to play that one there, tucked away.
Service over,
13-16. Going to be out, maybe helped by the sideways drift as well, just to push that further away. Maintaining that 4-point lead for now. Actually 7 all since the interval. So much better from the Japanese. But they need more than that, don't they? Given that they had a 6-point gap earlier. Doesn't make it over Midorikawa.
19-13.
mentioned. And it's been very one-sided in their previous matchups. Oh, that's gone out. Well, that's got to be frustrating. For the Japanese. And they looked in a really good position to finish that off. We've got 7 game points here for Zheng and Huang. One saved.
Service over, 14-20.
Well, with that 15th point on the board, it's actually the most 20. Number of points they've ever scored in a first game against Zheng and Huang. They don't care, though. They want to win this if they can. Still a long way from their opponents.
Game.
Who take the first game.
First game won by
Zheng and Huang. Were comfortable at the interval. It was a nice fight back from the Japanese after the break. But it wasn't to be quite enough from them. It ended up being 10-all following the interval. But they had that huge deficit to come back from. And that's what set up the Chinese to win that first game, 21-15.
ファンに落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、背に落ちないように、
20 seconds. That's it. Thank you. Second game. Level. Play.
Change of ends, let's see if it suits the Japanese pair a little bit more. Got off to a much better start than it did in the previous game. The problem is sustaining it, that's what's been the real issue.
Service over, one.
Looking at the Chinese pair as well. Cheer from the crowd. The Chinese played two Japanese pairs last year in finals at the Malaysia Open and right here at the Indonesia Open. Both times it was Yuta Watanabe and Anissa Higashino. Both times they won very comfortably. killed off there by Midorikawa.
Serve is over. 3-2.
Yeah, that's not the kind of shot you expect from Zheng Sewei. These pairs have met in Indonesia before, the Indonesia Open last year. In the round of 16, so that's quite telling. They won that 21-14, 21-17. Flick serve. She gets it back, Saito, but puts herself immediately under pressure. Interception there. It's not well long, isn't it? Very wayward shots from Chinese.
5-3.
Well, this is an excellent start, really is, from the Japanese pair. Nice run of points here. Three in a row.
4-6.
Nice and aggressive. They seem to prefer that far end at the moment, both pairs. A lead of 3. This is an unusual situation for Zheng and Huang. Work here for the Japanese. They're working their opponents, and oh dear.
Service over.
Hugely frustrating when they're in control of the shuttle there completely on the serve, and Saito knows it. Ever on the World Tour for Saito and Midorikawa. And, maybe that's a lack of experience on the big stage. Showing here they had that decent lead that's been whittled down to just a single point. Shoots wide there.
10-7.
I mean, that record is unbelievable.
Oh.
Finals,
that was over.
Points in this.
8-10.
Well, this year, the Chinese pair played in the Malaysia Open, lost in the quarters to Kim Wonho Jong Na-eun, who made it to the final in the end. So we go to the interval with the
nine, almost ten,
just trailing by the 1 point. Good defense from the Chinese. Square. This is a pair that have in their career won 37 finals and lost just 9. More than 85%. It's incredible. Took away Wang Yajong. And they go to the break.
11-10.
With a slender 1 point lead, the Chinese pair. They've already won the first game. Let's see a comeback here for the Japanese. Careers, the Chinese pair played. Played six Japanese pairs in finals. Five of them. The only time they have struggled, the only time they lost, I should say, is in the very first final against Japanese pair. That was the All England final against Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. Since then, they've had five straight wins against that Japanese pair. So struggle against Japanese overall. Keeping themselves in the hunt as much as they can.
11. 13.
And that overall record against Japanese pairs is also enviable. 31 wins out of 36. The last Japanese pair they played was this very pair, the Kumamoto Masters Japan.
Service four call, too high. Service over, 14-12.
Oh, just snatching at that.
15-12.
These are the things you can't afford to do when you're playing a pair. Like Zheng and Huang. Should be out. Oh, it's going to get challenged.
You don't give Midorikawa challenges.
Maybe a little bit hopeful.
Out. challenge and
well
successful.
I thought it was a little closer than one that, but no, it was out.
16-12. Play.
Japanese bear with that struggle against Chinese overall. Just 3 wins out of 16.
17.
That is
12.
Tough, isn't it? The last win against the Chinese pair was Zheng Jing and Zheng Feng Wei at the quarterfinals of the Arctic Open. And they're now trailing by 5 here.
Now it's over. 13-17.
This year, Midorikawa and Saito lost to their compatriots Watanabe Higashino in the quarterfinals of the Malaysia Open. Got to round of 16 of the India Open, lost to Kim Wonho and Jong Na-eun. It's been an okay start to the year. They've got to the final here.
14-17. Service over. 18-14.
Struggled against this pair previously, as we said, though. Striking distance. Where you want to be within 3 points, though. That's all the Chinese pair need now to win this. And they're almost there.
Service over. 19,
they've only once 15. Beaten a top 5 pair, Midorikawa and Saito. That was Tom Jekyll and Delphine Del Rue in the German Open last year. It's going to be a bit tricky.
20, match point.
You would expect
15.
Between world number 1 and the world number 13. There are 5 match points here. Championship points now. One saved.
Service over
by Midorikawa.
20. Game.
And yet another title, and in fact, this is a record for Zheng Shengcui. Zheng Shengcui and Huang Yacheng, because a 5th title here has made them the competition's most decorated players. They were tied with Marcus Minaldi, Gideon,
and Huang Yacheng.
Kevin Sanjaya Sukamulyo. But now, with a 5th title, they are the most successful ever player or pairs at the Indonesia Masters. This tournament is their own, isn't it? Fantastic. They love it here in Indonesia, and Indonesia sure loves them. So Zheng Shengcui and Huang Yacheng, our top seeds from China, beat Hiroki Midorikawa and Natsu Saito of Japan. 21-15, 21-16, they've done it in 31 minutes. For any crumbs of comfort from the Japanese, it's the fact that they've scored their highest aggregate number of points against this Chinese pair. But as I said, scant consolation, because the Chinese outplayed them. They had their moments. The Japanese had little leads as well, which they couldn't hold on to. Chinese were just too good. 2018, 2019, 2020, 2022, and now 2024. Absolutely massive for them. Brilliant. And that's now joint with the Malaysia Open, where they've also won 5 times as a most successful tournament. And now a treat for everyone, we will have the prize presentation. And we're now moving on to the women's double. Zheng Xuxian and Zheng Yu of China take on their third seeds, the compatriots Liu Shengshu and Tan Ning. That's up next. Thank you. Welcome back to the Estora Senayan. A very good win there for Zheng Suwei and Huang Yachong in the mixed doubles final. Now it's time for the women's doubles. Zheng Shuxian and Zheng Yu, the third seeds from China.